Whether it's summer nights or summer days, we're glad to see y'all. One
summer night. Yes, we are.
I see Jeff Palladino coming from the Bronx.
Welcome, everyone. Welcome.
Welcome, everybody.
Morning, everyone. Welcome, welcome, welcome.
It's one of the four biggest days of the Big Bang. Jonathan Bisson with the same hairdo I'm rocking.
Welcome, Cindy. What's up, Dana Jones?
Welcome, everybody.
Welcome, David.
Hey there, Gabby Logan. Good to see you.
What's up, Gabby? How are you? Good morning, good morning.
Christy Glenn, Big Bang Virtual Super, Super Veteran.
Welcome, Heidi. Welcome, Heidi. We fell in love. Welcome, Keith.
That's right, it's a summer morning. We're recovering from the summer night.
Welcome, Alyssa.
Colin Goffin, you never know what time it is, but he's always going to be there for you.
Welcome to thank you.
Yeah. Listen to that harmonious close to that song. And it's a harmonious open. Good morning, everybody. Welcome. Welcome back. I'm Andrew Frischman, the co-ED of Big Picture Learning. I'm excited.
Yeah.
But I got to say, excited, that is not a word that really like captures what Big Bang is. I have been thrilled. I have been jazzed. I have been pumped up, energized. I've been inspired by all the students, the educators, the leaders, all these sessions where you've all been going out on these Leaving to Learns. It's a lot. It's a lot of joy. Joy is an act of resistance. And while we've been doing all this, there's been a lot going on out there in the world around us. Usually when we got these Big Bang conferences, we can get together, we can take some space, we can make some space in our lives, we can step away from some of our daily lives and family responsibilities. However, I really want to acknowledge and just appreciate all the additional commitments that you've all made, that we've all made in order to engage in and with this Big Bang this year. And that can be a lot, trying to balance those different pieces of our lives. You know, at least for me, I know, for my students, when I was an advisor at the Met in Providence, at the Met in Sacramento, a little shout out to Rhode Island and California and all the states in between, and really for educators and leaders all around the world, this past year, it's been a lot. It's really important to slow some things down. We know from the Big Picture Living Initiative, one of the six ways we got to be taking care of our health is managing stress. As Big Picture Living students call it, we need to chill. Got to chill. You got to step off that gerbil wheel. You got to take a few minutes to pause and reflect. You remember John Dewey always said, it's only part of the learning that's in the experience. It's always complemented by the reflection and then sharing those reflections with others. And that's what we wanted to open with today. So what we're going to be doing is taking about 5 minutes for some self-reflection. You're going to have a bit of time. It's up to you if you want to be writing in a notebook, if you can pull your notebook out from that swaggerific box that you received, or if you want to write a little bit on a Padlet. We're going to start up some real chill music, and we're going to ask you to respond to these four questions that I've just dropped into the chat. You know, what has it been about this Big Bang experience that's resonated with you and why? What's one topic or practice that you're most interested in implementing in this coming school year? What are you still curious about? What do you want to learn a little bit more about? Or who would you like to connect with and why? And so what we're going to do is take 5 minutes. I want to ask people to actually turn off their cameras for a moment. You can listen to some quiet meditative music. If you want to step away and write, you can do that. And then 5 minutes on the dot, when you reappear back here, we're then going to place folks into breakout groups of 3 to 4 people. So you'll get a chance for a small intimate conversation. It might be some old friends that you get to reconnect with. It might be some brand new friends that you get to make, but it'll be a chance for you to share some responses to these questions. I think I saw that Anna put the link to the Padlet. So again, if you're the kind of person who wants to be typing away some answers, you can do that in the Padlet. Or if you want to take a few moments and use your digits with a pencil or a pen, you can do that in the notebook. So I think we're ready for a little bit of music to be queued up. We're going to take 5 minutes now and then come back and we'll have 10 minutes in those small groups. Then we'll come back as a whole group and recap a little bit. So let us begin the 5 minutes. I will model by stopping my video as well. We got a little meditative music to reflect with.
Carlos hitting us with a soundtrack right now.
I thought that was you.
We're going to begin with a few minutes of silence, just total silence, and then we'll have a little music start in a few. I know it is a difficult and cardinal sin to interrupt the dulcet tones of Edith Piaf, but I'm going to ask folks to wrap up their last thought, whether you're typing a note into the Padlet or finishing a sentence or two in your notebook, and prepare yourself to be magically transported through the small group breakout time warp. You'll be headed off into a group of 3 to 4 folks to share a little bit on these same 4 questions. And we'll return at 21 minutes past the hour. Thanks so much, everybody. I see everyone just returning back in, which is fantastic. And I just want to say I saw an absolute just flood of amazing responses coming through on that Padlet. If I could peer through the screen and see all of your individual notebooks, I'm sure I would see a bunch of additional great reflections. Just really glad that folks had a time to share some reflections and some connections. What we're going to do now is do a whip and go around, and every single person is going to share one comment. So you can just call in. No, I'm kidding. I wish we had an opportunity.
Don't do that.
See, I got you. I got a few people there. I would love to hear from each and every one of you, but we only have time for a few quick comments. So if you want to come off mute, you drop something in the chat. If there's something you put in the Padlet or some burning thing that you want to share, a reflection on this amazing Big Bang week, we'd love to hear. Who's going to be the brave soul to break that seal?
I could.
Please do. Who are you? Identify yourself.
This is Demetrius Mayberry from Fresno, California.
Yes, Demetrius. Good to hear from you. Tell me what you're thinking.
Very nice. Right now, I'm loving the Leaving to Learn, although we didn't get to do it, just the idea of the staff leaving to learn. I just feel like it's really authentic, and it's going to go a long way to helping us get our students to understand, you know, the power in leaving to learn.
That's right.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Looking for another soul as brave as Demetrius out there.
I'll piggyback on that. This is Manette Motanon. I'm from Montgomery, Alabama. And I'll piggyback on that because I was saying that I had to be brave and bold to do the leave to learn. And I want my scholars to do that. I want them to be brave and I want them to step out there. And I kept telling myself when I didn't want to do it and I was going to do something else, I said, well, you would want your students, your scholars to do it. So you do it because that's the modeling. So I agree with Demetrius.
Appreciate you, Manette, being brave for the students, being brave with the students, right? That's how we're going to be able to get
That's
there.
That's right.
All right. I think we've got time for one more out there.
Don't be shy.
All right, I'll go. I'm going to give a hat tip to Eunice, our wonderful advisory leader. And she said, I was talking about something and I prefaced it with like, I know this takes a lot of time. And other people were saying, well, we don't have enough time to do this, or if only we had more time. And she said, don't drink the Kool-Aid of saying that you always don't have enough time, right? And I thought about that. I said, you know, how often, like, catch your language, right? How often do we say, I don't have enough time, I'm too busy? Like, and usually it's prefacing something like, this great best practice, I would do it if only I had enough time. So kudos, Eunice. You're in my brain.
Thank you, Sammy, and thank you, Eunice. And thank you to the funky, funky meters who remind us that if I need more time for my dreams to come true, that is the kind of funky patience we need to have. Let's make the space for those kinds of priorities. I am glad to hear about all that. One of the things that I heard in there in the highlights and coming up on the Padlet again and again was all these leaving to learns. I know we saw a quick view of the map yesterday, but son, you want to show us a little update? Tell us about how that leaving to learn turned out over this week.
Yeah, it's, I mean, the side conversations, the hashtags on social media, y'all, we really, really, really appreciate folks going out into the communities and really embracing our Leaving to Learns. We hope folks really, like, internalize the power of the community as your school with your young people. And really, like, authenticity is the name of the game here. And these authentic learning experiences are what we're trying to offer to our young people. So I just wanted to shout out a couple of people that were able to upload experience and share some pictures. My challenge and also invitation is everyone else to please continue to post. You'll need to learn. Shay went to Colonel's Popcorn and the Cobb Show in Atlanta. We got Earth Dance Farm. With Keith and Brenda. Let's see what else we got here. We got a scavenger hunt in Boise. Let's see what else we got over here. Orangino Farm over here. We just got so many examples so far that folks were able to check it out. And we wanted to honor in this map. If you want to check this map out, I'm going to drop the link in 1 second. But you can email with a QR code. Please fund. Let's know you're leaving this global movement around Leaving to Learns, and we just want to continue it. So please join us and upload your Leaving to Learn.
Absolutely. Thank you, son, for showing us that visual. Thank you for showing us that visual so much, son. And I think, you know, as I've visited big picture schools around the network, getting to have some kind of that visual of like, here's where we all are. If you can put big giant map up in the entryway, put up some push pins and show where all your young people are out having their internships. Put up little, you know, blurbs about what it is that you've been doing. Post some photos of you and your students out there in those places around your community. That can be so powerful and inspiring for young people to actually see themselves out there in that world. So think about ways you can do some of these pieces. And I'm jealous. I want to get to every single one of those places. Now, speaking about the map and all the places that Big Picture is showing up, I want to mention just three things. Big Picture Learning is always in the process of growing and expanding. And if you haven't spotted it already, there's a position available right now. We're looking for a person to do some work in the Kansas City area, helping to grow LTIs, learning through interests and emblaze support. We're also going to be growing in the Mid-Atlantic. We're looking for someone to help facilitate a community of practice that'll range from between Washington, D.C. to New York City. And third, out in California, we got a lot of stuff going on. We're looking for a California school design coach with a particular focus on LTIs and emblaze implementation support. So if that's you right now, or if you're interested, or if you know some great people, please be on the lookout for information about those postings. And if it's not the right match for you right now, who knows what there might be out there in the future. And speaking of who knows what might be out there in the future, Chris Jackson's gonna tell us some announcements on what's in the immediate near future. So what's coming? You got a Zoom bomber right behind you. There's Jeff Palladino right there.
All right, folks. Well, we're very excited that we're not excited. It's the final day of Big Bang, but we're excited about what is part of the final day of Big Bang. So I want to lead you through some things. If you missed it, the link for the Leaving to Learn map on the website is bplevents.org/LTL. And as you just saw from Sun's screen share, there's a lot more dots than are here. This is my screen grab from yesterday. I feel like the dots have doubled. I'll just hammer this home point. You know, if you have important nuggets to share, whether it's things that Eunice has said, or whether it's things that Jeff Palladino is saying, spread it out to the ethosphere. Use the Bang 2021 on social media. Tag us. Today is day 4. We've got our final advisory in just a few minutes. And then at 1:30, we have our final set of breakthrough sessions, which include our Puzzle Pieces podcast. There's a session on identity, wellness, and empowerment in middle school projects. There's a session on focusing on SEL collaboration and advisee one-on-ones. And there's a session on designing strong learning through internship experiences. And then it's the last day of Big Bang, so we go out with a big bang. We have our keynote conversation later this afternoon at 3 Eastern time with Sonia Renee Taylor. She's both an author and an activist, and she will be coming to us before the sun rises in New Zealand. We're pretty excited to have a conversation with her later today. And then that's followed by the encore session. The reason I'm joined today by Jeff Palladino is because I'm here at Fannie Lou Hamer Freedom High School in the Bronx. Our encore session today will be coming to you live from a couple of different locations, including this one. So we're excited to be here. Don't miss that. I'm keeping it a little bit under wraps because we'd like to have it be somewhat of a surprise. But two things you should know is that during that session, we'll be giving out our annual alumni and advisor award. So if nothing else, come for those. And then this evening is our after hours celebration, which is going to be a combination of cooking and partying with DJ Kulasan from Seven Oaks Met. All right, let's talk about what's going on tomorrow. Wait a second, there's no Big Bang tomorrow. However, tomorrow morning, you're going to receive your final email from me, which will contain a number of reminders, a link to provide us with feedback, some information about some other things we have coming up. I know a lot of folks have been really interested in learning how they can get more of those LTI cards, and link to how you can buy those. One of those things that won't be in that email is this announcement. All of the sessions you've been a part of, we are recording, and probably in a couple of weeks, you'll start to see those appearing on our YouTube channel. So if you're like, hey, I really missed that great session, or I really enjoyed the session and I want to share it with a peer, start keeping an eye on the YouTube channel, Big Pictures, and they'll start appearing there. Beyond tomorrow, January. What's going on in January? We are, hopefully, fingers crossed, going to be back in person for our 2022 leadership conference to be held in San Diego. And if my peers could go ahead and change their Zoom backgrounds over for me, looking at Jeff's screen since I can't see it, we will be in bright and sunny San Diego from January 24th through 26th for the 2022 leadership conference. Later on today, at some point, the BPL events website will change over from Big Bang to the leadership conference. Your Zoom links for today will still be up there. So if you arrive on this website and wondering where you are, you're in the right place. Those Zoom links won't go away until tomorrow or later, but it will switch over. And this is a new thing we're doing. Used to be that every year we would send you a different link for each conference. We want BPL events to be the place that you go from here on forth to find out what's the next Big Bang, what's the next leadership conference, so you don't have to keep moving around. I should also mention, and you can barely see it here, we're excited to announce that we're working with our friends at Hip Hop Ed, and they will be providing our keynote cipher at that conference. Timothy Jones, Christopher Emden, a couple other special guests will be joining us in San Diego. You don't want to miss out on that. Registration will go live today. We're very excited about that as well. As I mentioned, all this information will be found on BPL events at some point today. Bookmark it. Visit it, share it with your friends. We hope to see folks in person in San Diego. That's it for me. Hope folks have a wonderful day. I don't know if Son or Andrew or anyone else has some parting words, but let's have a great day.
Parting words are, how much great stuff is there and how could we possibly have enough time to get it all in? We need more time. That's what we need. We need more time. And we're gonna keep on making time today. We're gonna keep on making time every day until we get it out. So love y'all, have a great, fantastic day, and we'll see you in some sessions.